Hey, Tom here from the Run Testers. In this video, me and Nick are going to be taking a look at the Asics Gel Nimbus 23 running shoe. Let's take a look. So the Asics Gel Nimbus 23 is the latest in a very long line of shoes from Asics, designed for cushioning, comfort, and just basically lots of mileage, whether that's daily miles or long distance running. It has a flight foam midsole, which is quite a cushioned material, but it still has quite a lot of responsiveness in it as well, so it's not too soft. It's quite a plush shoe. The upper, there's a lot of padding on it, especially in the tongue section here. The upper at the front, it's a fairly thick material, definitely a lot thicker than a lot of the light materials that you see on a lot of shoes these days. But it is also fairly breathable, but it's by no means a lightweight shoe. It also has Asics' gel technology that sits mainly in the back section here. You can kind of see that. That gel that sits there, which is meant to absorb impact and add a bit of cushioning to the heel section there. I think there's actually some more in the shoe as well that sits in the front, but you can't actually see that. So overall, it's just to add an extra bit of cushioning with that gel technology. Asics have also added in their Trustic technology to the shoe, which in the case of this shoe is a very minimal stability block that sits in the arch section here. It's by no means a stability shoe, but that's just meant to add a little bit more stability as you're running. So let's take a look at the all important stats. The price is £155 in the UK and $150 in the US. The weight for men in a size 9 is 310 grams or 10.9 ounces. For women, it's 260 grams or 9 ounces, and that's in a size 7. The drop is actually 10 millimeters for men, although for women it's actually 13 millimeters. So apparently because that extra drop is beneficial for women running in the shoe. Okay, so Nick, how was the fit for you?
So I actually found that the shoe was completely true to size. I didn't really have any kind of note on the fit at all, except this tongue is very big and spongy, isn't it? When you tie the laces, it was like coming riding up my foot. But in general, other than that, no real note. It's a very comfortable shoe. The upper was nice and it was true to size for me.
Yeah, it's pretty much the same for me. I did feel that it was quite roomy. Okay. Definitely didn't feel narrow in any way. But I read a few reviews on it that said that it was a bit narrow, which I didn't get at all. I didn't think it was narrow in any way. But yeah, very plush, thick shoe, but very comfortable for me. Fit true to size.
Yeah, I'd say probably has a little bit less padding around it than some of like the Sauconys, but the tongue is really, really padded.
Yes, yeah, yeah. It's like a slipper, isn't it? So, what was it like to run in for you?
So I think the highlight, really, it was a really solid shoe to run in, I suppose, for me. Like, I found that it took maybe 20k, about three runs to break in. It was quite firm at first. I just didn't really mind, but it was quite responsive and firm, but actually softened a bit. It's still not like really cushioned or bouncy, like some of the kind of modern shoes with their kind of different foams that are much more kind of, bouncy and springy. But basically, it felt very solid, the ride. I've done about 70K, I think, did a lot of easy running in it, and it obviously was fine for that. I did a kind of steady 10K, reasonably kind of more like a tempo 10K, and I was impressed by how quick it felt, actually. And I did a pretty fast half marathon, but again, just more like a steady pace, like heart rate-wise. And after that, I had kind of no real notes. It's kind of a shoe that, you know, doesn't leave a huge lasting impression, but you're never really disappointed in it either. So, it's quite a hard shoe to really sum up.
Yeah, we have a few of these shoes on the Run Testers where when you finish running in it, you don't really think that was an amazing run, or you don't think that was a bad run, which I suppose is a nice position to be in for a shoe if you're not expecting anything from it. I've really enjoyed running in it. I've not done as many miles as you in it. I've probably done about 60K in it. My longest run was 10 miles in it. But every time I've just found it to be a really comfortable, enjoyable shoe. And as you say, it's not a slow shoe. There's a lot of cushioning in it, but I didn't feel I had to run slow. I felt I could pick up the pace quite nicely. Having said that, it's not a fast shoe either. It just kind of sits in that middle where you can kind of have a comfortable long run and not really worry too much about it. Aside from that, I didn't really, as you say, didn't really pick up a lot from it. What did you think about this gel section in it? This is the first time I've used one of the Gel Nimbus shoes from Asics. Did you notice anything from it?
No, not really. It didn't feel like really spongy or cushy or anything like that. It definitely just feels like kind of an EVA, standard EVA shoe. Like I said, it's pretty versatile because of that. I think it doesn't become too cushy and just completely an easy day shoe. But yeah, I probably wouldn't use it for fast sessions. But actually, one note I did have was, like, I think I last used a Gel Nimbus shoe, it must have been, I think, late teens generation, maybe 18, 19, something like that. And I couldn't really say that I've noticed a massive difference in the rides between these. I think if it's a shoe, if you love the Gel Nimbus range, I think it would just be a perfectly good follow-on from the previous version. But yeah, it doesn't really have one outstanding quality, which in a way is, I guess, kind of a quality that stands out. You know, it's a very versatile, solid shoe that kind of just you forget about. It's on your foot, really.
kind of just an old reliable that does the job and keeps you happy.
Yeah, it's like, I mean, it's the shoe that's been around forever kind of thing. It's that EVA style. Asics does it very well. Like, a lot of, you know, there's a lot more excitement, I guess, around shoes that bring in new foams and new materials. But at the end of the day, this is, you know, a reliable shoe. And I will say, actually, what's quite important is it's a quite heavy shoe. Like, I think mine was 324 grams for a UK 9. Yeah. But it doesn't feel like that on the foot. Like, I wasn't feel like I was lugging around a heavy shoe, which I have had with some of the kind of 300 gram plus. It doesn't feel like that at all to me.
Yes, I thought the same thing. Actually, when I took it out of the box, I instantly thought, this is going to be a heavy running shoe. It looks like it should be heavy. And it is relatively heavy if you're looking at the actual weight. But yeah, it doesn't run like that. It's quite a comfortable and quite nippy little shoe if you're using it for longer runs. Okay, great. So yeah, pretty good for general all-round running, but nothing that exciting from it.
Yeah, exactly. I'd say it's a good versatile training shoe. You could use it for if you're fairly new to running, I think it'd be quite a good all-rounder option. But yeah, if you're if you've got a couple of shoes in rotation, this will be more your kind of easy tempo side of things rather than your speed sessions.
Yeah, and there's also a little. It's not a support shoe; it's a neutral shoe, but there is this sort of minimal bit of plastic. That sits just in the arch section here, which is meant to add like a bit of stability as you're running. Did you spot anything with that?
Actually, I'm glad you answered that, because one of my notes over here is stable. Yeah, it's stable. Yeah.
It does feel stable.
I think mainly there is to compare it to Asics' kind of big exciting new shoe was the Nova Blast, and it's nothing like that to me. Like, Nova Blast I found very wobbly, and I found this, like I say, it's one of those things, again, where you go, oh, that's pretty stable, and then you forget about it because the shoe is just performing as it should.
And also, there's quite a nice bit of rubber on the outside as well, I spotted. I think that's probably... It's not massive. It's not making it really heavy, I don't think, but it's a nice layering of rubber on it, so it's probably designed for a little bit of kind of long-term durability, I think.
Definitely. I would be surprised if the shoe wasn't durable. I'd expect it to go well over kind of 500 miles, but... you know, we haven't run it that much, but yeah, I does seem like a shoe that's going to be built to handle a lot of training.
So what's your verdict? Who is it for? Is it worth getting?
So I guess it's a good workhorse of a training shoe for a lot of people. I think people who are new to the sport, looking for a comfortable, stable shoe that they can do all their running in, would also be quite well served by it. I think for someone like myself who does have racing shoes, speed day shoes in the lineup, it would really be something I'd restrict probably to kind of easy and long runs. I think even, although it felt perfectly fine on a tempo run, I think that for me, there are shoes that I find just a little bit more enjoyable to run in maybe. Things like Saucony's Endorphin Speed, even the Nike Pegasus 37, I think it's got a bit more kind of bounce to it for me. So I didn't dislike anything about the shoe, to be honest. I don't think there's anything really wrong with the shoe. I think the problem more is, firstly, what else is out there, which is a lot of quite exciting shoes that are maybe a bit more fun to run in, and also its price. I was quite surprised to see £155 on the shoe. I think that, you know, that's putting it, you know, there are carbon racers like the Hoka Rocket X for £140. I mean, obviously this isn't designed to do that, but you can get very, very good, durable, versatile daily trainers for around £100, and I'm not sure there's enough here that really sells me on the extra money. I don't know about you. How about you?
Yeah, I mean, it's, for me, I think it kind of fits into that same bracket as maybe something like the Glycerin 18 or maybe I haven't tried it, but maybe this Saucony Triumph, something like that, that has got a bit more kind of cushioning to it. But I definitely, as we said, I'm not really, whenever I finish a run in this, I'm not thinking that was an amazing run, but I'm not thinking it's a bad run either. Whereas with the glycerin, I did enjoy the runs. I think, and it's slightly cheaper as well, I think the glycerin's around £140. So when you get into that realm of £155 for a shoe, there's a lot of competition out there, and you're probably going to be wanting an experience that you say, you know, I'm going to spend £105, I want a great shoe. And if it's just going to be something that does the job, as you say, there's lots of other options out there.
Definitely,
I think if you had this shoe, you'd be happy with it. It's definitely, there's a nice bit of stability, it's a nice bit of cushioning, it's very comfortable to wear. But for maybe for £110, I'd be happy with that. But £155, I think there's other options that you should be going for.
Definitely. And like you mentioned, a few of those classics, we really like the glycerin. I do think that's a more comfortable shoe. I think you can use the glycerin for the same runs as you would this shoe, and it would be more comfortable. I think if you are a new runner, the glycerin is such a great step in comfort feel that maybe that's probably something you prefer. There are a few shoes I like this more than, though. I actually like it more than the Saucony Ride 13, which I wasn't a huge fan of. I know you and Kieran and Mike actually liked it quite a lot. And I liked it more than the newest Saucony Triumph, actually, the Triumph 18. But the Triumph 17, I think, is better than both the show shoes. It's a really cushioned shoe that does have a bit more pop in it when you do try and up the pace. And I still think Nike Pegasus 37 just is... I really like that shoe. I've used it a lot this year, and I've not really had a problem with it for that kind of daily training. And it's £105, often reduced to like around 70. It's just a lot better value, I think, and it's going to be really durable as well. Actually, even like the Adidas Ultra Boost, probably a bit more than this.
Really?
Even though I know it gets a lot of stick, that shoe. So you're exactly right. Like, if you had the shoe, I'd have no problem having it and using it. And if you're a big Gel Nimbus fan of the line, you're not going to be disappointed, I think, by getting this newer version. It's going to be the same shoe as you're used to. There's a couple of little tweaks, but there's nothing really major change to the shoe, as far as I can tell. But yeah, it's really pricey, and just the shoe market right now is so competitive. I think it might struggle a little bit to win over a lot of people compared to some of the other options.
So what are we thinking? Maybe if you're looking at getting a shoe of this type, the Gel Nimbus 23, maybe wait for a bit until it gets a bit cheaper in price, and then it's probably going to become a bit more viable as an option, as opposed to £155, which is a little bit too much for what you get.
Yeah, I think that's definitely right. I wonder if it's the kind of shoe that's in running shops a lot and might see discounts, and you get to try it out there. I think what you might, if you do go and try it in a shop, I think it's worth trying something like the glycerin. I mean, the glycerin has that amazing first feel when you step into it, and I think people will probably, you know, you can compare the two. If you like a slightly firmer ride, to be fair, the Asics is quite a nice option. And people aren't always about cushioning, I suppose.
Yeah. Okay, great. Well, thank you very much.
Nice one. See you later.
So that's it from us on the Asics Gel Nimbus 23 running shoe. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that little bell icon. And don't forget to check out some of the other videos we've got on the channel, from the best watches out there to headphones and loads of running shoes. Thanks a lot for watching. Catch you later.